They would carry that balloon somewhere else. But we would come and leave. And I remember, even in church, me and his aunt, who was my friend, we the first two got saved. We were the president and vice president of the youth department. We were 17. I'll never forget it. Me and his aunt, Tony, we was the vice president, and the man came and just talking just like this, and he asked us a question. He said, how many of y'all, who's your favorite singers? We said, Whitney Houston, Michael Jackson, LL Cool J, you know. And he said, oh, okay. This man is dead, as a matter of fact. It was Lawrence Bell. And he said, well, I wish your parents weren't here. We could really talk then. He said, have you really listened to music? I said, oh, no, I didn't. Because I was a dancer. I just liked the beat. The beat drop, I'm moving. I don't want to hear no music, but the words, the lyrics. I don't care about the lyrics. And he began to break down me love. And his daughter, Monica, was saying, I said, oh my God, soft as a pillow and hard as a, what? That's what he's saying. We just, we kicking it. He's talking about all this food. I said, oh, because one thing I didn't want my, dude, my sister to get pregnant early. So I said, Lord, if I mess around and do something dumb, it's going to fall on my sister. I always had that in my head. I don't want to do nobody wrong because I have a sister, and I don't want to go to jail. If somebody hurts my sister, I'm going to kill them. I'm going to try anyway. So I had a mother, and I see my mother go through abuse and all that foolishness. And it would seem like every year when I went to Trinity Holiness Church, there was an apostle would come every year, and I would sit and look. And he would say, God's going to use you in the apostolic every year. And I just said, yeah, right. I don't even like church. Every year. And I was never the popular people. I'm talking to somebody. I was never the popular people. And I remember going to Saturday, Holy Church of Deliverance. Bless their hearts. And I remember Bishop Alexander made four praise and worship teams. She said, Dwayne, Carla, and Danielle. Vanessa, Mike, and Chris, they were horrible. But it was three of us. They were horrible, honey. Dion, Jermaine, Stacy. And so we would come the first of the month. And I remember it was one day, we was just up there, and something happened. Something happened that did not happen before. And I don't know how I'm doing that holler. Honey, that holler came out of that belly. I said, ooh. I started exhorting. I said, I've never done that before. And the more I understood what my gift was, that's why these young boys can't say nothing to me, because I got it the right way. Come on, Hannah. I got it the right way. I went to Bible study. I went to prayer. I cleaned up the church. Y'all hear me? I made sure the woman of God didn't want for nothing. And when I got married, we did it together. And it was only about three couples that gave, and we was one of them. Chairs and carpet and doors and all of that. And we did not, at one time we gave $1,400, my check. And I said, throw that out there, because y'all think I've been poor for years. I threw my check out, and we lost our house. It's right on New Street. But something transformed that year too. I said, you know what, I'm going to believe you, God, because I know this is a real woman of God, and I know that I have grown some in this ministry, so I'm not going to do that whole sulking and getting depressed because we don't have a house. In 2 weeks, we had a house, the best house we ever had, right next to his old school, 506 Pear Street. It was an awesome house, and we let people stay with us. Uh-huh. Everybody, families and friends, everybody, y'all were here, man. And you know, I thought about you the other day, how we went through in Laurel at that dumb house. And I thought about you, Vanessa had worked at this place, and Hannah had the girls come over there. She got paid for the biz. Champagne taught her how to dance. Remember the little Nico girl? Champagne would teach her how to dance. And I said, this Hannah, and then we let the saints stay with people, and oh man, I can really dance now. We let the saints stay with people, the saints don't do right. Hannah, can you let her stay with you? Yeah. And they don't pay bills. And they leave stuff under the beds. And they nasty and dirty. And then she finally said, you got to go. And then the people try to throw it off on you. And I'm going to help y'all boys with something while y'all listen. And y'all girls. I had this 26-year-old man that I know what I'm talking about. They want to have a meeting so bad. We got to have a meeting. your daughter is hurt. Number one, now, he has a very good chance of being America's president. A very good chance of being America's president. And off of the platform, that guess what? I'm not no politician. I'm a businessman.
Right.
They don't know how to run no business. You can't make no Mexico pay me. He said, watch me. Yes, I can. But you can make the tariffs go up. He said, watch me. Just let me do it. This man, if you have ever been to Atlantic City, you're going to see his Trump Tower.
Mm-hmm.
It's lit up real nice. He built that. He's not worried about y'all. He's not worried about people coming. And that's why he says what he wants. Wouldn't you? Who can stop him?
Right.
And now the people, America has voted. They want him because they don't trust politicians. He's an outsider. What you saying, Apostle Roach? Aren't you tired of the same people getting the big churches and the same people getting the loans and the same people getting the grants? It's time for the outsider to get it. Because people want realness. And one thing about the city, we're going to be real. We're going to tell you what we like, what we don't, if we like it, if we don't. And people need that. We are not playing around with deliverance. We're not playing around with your education. We're not playing around with your child. So why not can we have it? And you want to open up your mouth today and say, I thank God for the outside ministry. Thank you for the outside ministry. Can't understand it last week, but now I understand. And my point was this woman right here that has helped all those people. God has her in a position now where she can do what she wants to do and really help her. And I do believe it's from her labor that she's done all these years. And all those people that have talked about her and lived with her, you know, the saints talk about trying to live with you. They will talk about you and they'll live with you and inconvenience you.
Right.
Yeah. Inconvenience you and your family, they're going to talk about you. Y'all hear me? And that's a living example. We got to go into the Word of God and look at Abigail. And Deborah, she's right there.
Right there.
And that's a good segue. She got something tomorrow, I think it is, ain't
I canceled that one because whatever. But I have on the 8th, but it's on the 15th now. It's a jewelry party that we're having.
Right on the 8th.
Huh, Paparazzi jewelry party.
I saw that.
And then on June the 12th. We're having the auction thing, but I have food and stuff.
I want to eat at the wrong place tomorrow. That's okay. My point is support.
Support.
Yeah. Because one day you're going to have something, you want somebody to support you.
That's it.
Pastor Calvin got his little groove back on.
Yeah.
And help y'all women beautify yourselves. Praise the Lord.